Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I am going to demonstrate how you can set component visibility on record page. Before starting the demonstration, if you want to watch more Salesforce training videos, you can go to description of this video and you will find links of all the playlists related to Salesforce videos there. So you can follow them. Now, let's say this is account record page. So we have various components here. And let's say you place some component, maybe it is custom or standard, and you want to show that component with a particular condition, like you want to apply a filter condition for that component. So on my record page, you can see I have placed one screen flow. So now I'm going to tell you how I can apply filters for this component rendering. So for that, I need to click on this gear icon and I can select edit page. So Lightning App Builder is opening and account record page is available here. So you need to select the component on which you want to apply the filters. So I selected this create opportunity record flow. So at right hand side, you can see we can set component visibility. And if we click on this button like add filter, so we can apply the filter criteria here. So here we can search for the fields available on account. So let's say I'm selecting active equals to true, done. So this is my filter criteria. If account record is active or if it is equals to true, then this component will be displayed. So I'm clicking on done, clicking on save. So it is now changing, sorry, it is now saving the changes, clicking on back. So now we need to check the details. So here you can see now that screen flow is not displaying because active is false, right? And if I mark this active as true or yes, then automatically that screen flow will be rendering. Here you can see. So this way we can apply the component visibility with the help of filters. So again, I'm moving to edit page so that we can explore more that filter. So I'm clicking on add filter again. So I can choose more fields. So let's say account source equals to web, done. So here you can see more filter conditions are available, like show components when all filters are true, any filters are true, or the filter logic is met. So you can create your own filter logic with the help of AND and OR. So this is further options. Then here you can see after record field, we can choose the device as well. So form factor, and from here you can choose a device, like if device is desktop, then it will be rendering, or if it is mobile, then it will be rendering. And then advanced. So here you can click on select. And from here you can choose these four things, like user fields, permissions, device and record. So let's say if you want to apply some profile filter here, so you can go to permission and here you can search for profile. Sorry, that is an user, I guess. Yeah, so from here you can apply the profile. So these are the profile fields that you can choose and apply the conditions. So yeah, this way we can apply various filters so that we can set the component visibility on record page. So this you can apply for any standard or custom object. So it is very beneficial in real life, like if you're working on any project. So in some scenarios, we need the to set the component visibility. So that's why I created this video. So I hope you understood whatever I demonstrated in this video regarding setting the component visibility on record page. And if you want to watch similar kind of videos on Salesforce, so you can go to description of this video and you can find links of all playlists that those I created for Salesforce videos. So follow them and learn Salesforce. Thank you for watching this video.